This is Jay Arthur, author of the QI Macros. Let's look at how to use Excel's drawing tools to create flowcharts, value stream maps, other types of diagrams right in Microsoft Excel. Now Excel has like a little mini-Visio built in. So all you have to do is once you have a blank worksheet, you simply come up here to Insert, and under Illustrations, you can see we have Shapes. And once you're into the Shapes, you can see we have things like rectangles, boxes, flowcharts, stars and banners, all kinds of things, little callouts and so on. So we could actually take and grab the flowchart icon and then just simply pick and draw a box. Now once you've drawn the box, you can change the color of that box. Whatever is in there, you can change how it's arranged. And then we could type step one. And as you can see here, that's not centered, so we might have to come back in here and tell it to center things. But once we have that box, we can then copy that and paste it. And paste it again. All right, so now we have step two, and we have step three. Then we might also want to insert something like a decision diamond. Okay, so I can put in a decision diamond here. And again, I can make that be the color I want. And I could type decision. As you can see here, sometimes things wrap a little bit, so you might have to resize things so they look like what you want them to look like. And again, I might have to center that to make that work. So then once we have the boxes, we can connect them. And under shapes that are what are called lines and connectors here. And so I might want to use one of these angled connectors. And once you get over a box, you can see there's little connection points. And I can connect that to my decision. And then because I still have those shapes up here, these are more common shapes, I can continue to add those. And I can add it here. Then I can move that around. And so now I've created the start of a flowchart. All right, so it's pretty easy to get into Excel and start drawing shapes and things. And once you've done that, the format shapes will show up over here. Again, if I wanted to change this, I could say change the shape of that outline. And I might want to make the weight of it a little bit darker. Right, so I can adjust the look of this thing. And once you're all done, you know, you can actually turn off the grid lines in here so that your background is clear. But I like to use the grid lines to align things. All right, in the QI macros, we have a variety of fill-in-the-blank templates for similar things, like flowcharts. And so we have a flowchart, or we have a swim lanes flowchart. So this is a great starter kit, right? And so if I need to, you know, copy this box, I can paste that box over here. And now I have a new box, and I could then connect that to my decision box if I wanted to. So this is just some thinking about how you could start to move forward to draw those kinds of charts. The QI Macros also has other things like fishbone diagrams. And we have other tools under our diagrams. Might be a mind map. What does a mind map look like? Well, it might look like that. All right, so there's starter kits in the QI macros to help you start drawing all these things. Now, the other thing about this I like is because this is all in Excel and it's not in Visio, most people have Excel, but not everybody has Visio. So this makes it a lot easier to share your presentations with other people because you do it in Excel, not in Visio. That's just a little bit about how to go about creating different diagrams using Excel's drawing tools.